fog drifting over San Francisco Bay. Have you heard a Bob White calling in the Carolina Pines? Or heard the bellow of a diesel in the Appalachian mines? Does the call of the Niagara thrill you when you hear her waters roar? Look with awe and wonder at her Massachusetts shore, where men who braved a hard new world first stepped on Plymouth Rock. You think of them when you stroll along a New York City dock? Have you seen a snowflake drifting in the Rockies way up high? Have you seen the sun come blazing down from the bright Nevada sky? Have you hailed of the Columbia as you rush into the sea? Or are you headed to Gettysburg? Struggle to be free? Have you seen the mighty Tetons? Watched an eagle soar? Have you seen the Mississippi roll along Missouri's shore? Have you felt a chill at Michigan when on a winter's day her waters rage along the shore in thunderous display? Does the word aloha make you warm? Do you stare in disbelief when you see the surf come roaring in at Waimea Reef? From Alaska's cold to the Everglades, from the Rio Grande to Maine, my heart cries out, my pulse runs fast, the mind turns away. You ask me why I love her? I've a million reasons why. My beautiful America, beneath God's wide, wide sky.
Ladies and gentlemen, I love those words of John Wayne. I hope that you love them as well. And that as you took a look at those flags today, especially that flag of red, white, and blue, the stars and stripes, and everything that it stands for, I hope that each and every one of us are proud of the fact that we are Americans. Ladies and gentlemen, as we continue to stand with joy in our hearts, our hats in our hands, we pay tribute to the flag that flies so proudly over the United States of America. And here this morning, we play for you our national anthem. Here it is.
Oh, say can you see by the dawn's early light what so proudly we hailed at the twilight's last gleaming, whose broad stripes and bright stars through the perilous fight, o'er the ramparts we watched were so gallantly streaming, and the rockets' red glare, the bombs bursting
to be an American. Well, ladies and gentlemen,